Research and development have been a long key activity in any developing or developed nation. R&D activities are not only generators of new knowledge, but they are also an essential factor in the growth in the economy. Malaysia has long recognized this fact and has worked to foster and nurture collaboration between researcher and the member of the industry. In Malaysia, research output has grown fivefold over the last decade, from 3,843 scientific research publications in 2007 to 19,176 in 2016. The availability of high qualified researchers is essential to innovation and promoting the scientific and technological development of a country. The brain drain issue in Malaysia, whereby many students who move up to tertiary level go abroad and some of them do not come home but remain or move to other countries like Singapore, China and the US. Furthermore, Malaysian researchers need to be an idea connector to the industry in dealing with the real world problem solving. There is a need to think out of the box and generate income from assets, investments and sponsorship. To continue producing knowledge via research, to generate income via commercialization and make impact on the community at the same time. Another problem in Malaysia higher education is that all the privileges are going to people who are already privileged. This is the major reason why universities are not what they should be. In today's world, it is more difficult for an individual to do research by themselves. Malaysia should work in concert across nation borders. Such cooperation can enhance the quality of research, reduce duplication, increase proposal development, create partnership, attract research funding, increase institutional competitiveness, and address issues and barriers that can only be solved by working together. While publish and perish mentality is rife in Malaysia, partnership places more emphasis on the need for quality contribution over the number of publications. In Malaysia, another barrier would be lack of two-way communication. Engagement is a platform where top management relays the information and expectation to the units and at the same time to get feedback from them. Recent economic headwinds in Malaysia may have caused a slowdown in R&D fundings. However, it is important for Malaysia to achieve an R&D intensity of at least 2% of the GDP by 2025, recognizing the importance of this investment in pursuit of the country's social economic well-being and future sustainability. Investing in R&D is necessary if Malaysia wants to advance its technological to be par with its peer abroad. Nothing than better policies are needed. The contribution of research in advancing science from idea, knowledge and talent in developing the field can help not only to drive global economic but also benefit society. Industry-academia partnership, for instance, can unlock and advance life-changing drug discoveries and significant proper human progression. The major complaint is that Malaysian universities are not producing the type of graduates needed to drive innovation and R&D, both which are necessary to move the nation forward. The first and foremost question is whether the education system is capable of producing the people that the Malaysia need to lead this endeavor. Malaysia must put more investment in R&D initiative to step up game if it wants to compete effectively in the international market. Sadly, a large proportion of research fundings go into making up proportional materials, travels and accommodation rather than the actual research. Having a research grant is seen by many researchers as a means to travel, be it to an exhibition or conference in some exotic part of the world. As a consequence, much research output has little community or market relevance. Also, in Malaysia, we see many papers with multiple authors, most of them are passengers to curry flavour for promotional purposes. Malaysian researchers are very hesitant to take up alternative method of research. The preferred route is safe on where other research tend to be duplicated within the Malaysian context. Despite such phenomenon, Malaysia has a great story in comparison to some of its neighbour countries. Malaysia has 5 research universities aimed to enculture R&D. Over the last few years, Malaysia universities have risen in various university rankings such as those published in QS and Time Higher Education. Our university improvement in R&D has certainly contributed to this. Malaysia R&D landscape has grown tremendously over the last decade. Moving forward, the focus will be on transitional research. Gandhi once said, "Education can certainly change the world." I believe R&D is a vital part of that education.